follow him. The man had discovered something. Look at Noah. In a corrupt society, in a violent environment, he walked with God. Was he happy at last? Talk to me now. I said, was he happy at last? He was in the ark. The flood was destroying others, but the same flood was lifting him higher. The same flood. And while inside that ark, he was sustained by God. He was sustained. Say, I don't know if you ever read Isaac blessing his son Jacob. When he blessed him with words. With words. He blessed Jacob. He spoke words upon him. He said, I give you the blessing of my father Abraham. And when he had blessed him and had gone, his brother Esau came and said, Daddy. And he said, hey, I've already blessed your brother. Then he said something that's so, oh boy. He said, and I have sustained him with plenty of corn and wine. He said, I have sustained him. A man is talking. Isaac, he had come to the point where he knew that when you know God, his word becomes him in you. He said, I have sustained him. Listen, this is a man sending his son into the world. He tells his brother, I have sustained him with plenty. Listen, the Bible does not tell us that he carried corn and gave to Jacob. He spoke words. He said, wherever you go, the presence, Amaya. This is the presence of the God of Abraham will go with you. He said, I have sustained him. How? By saying to him, you are blessed. Everything that you ever require is yours. A man was speaking. And then he said to Esau, he said, I have blessed him. And yea, he shall be blessed. He said, and I cannot reverse it. It cannot be changed. It cannot be changed. Look at Jacob. A rascal. A rascal. But he was a blessed man. He was not perfect in his ways, but he was a blessed man. He was even a cheat, but he was a blessed man. We'll show you why he was such a blessed man. Are you still in this place? Do you think Jacob or Isaac was more worthy of the kingdom of God than yourself? Listen, I'm loaded. I didn't come to collect something from you. No. No, I didn't come to collect something from you. I'm loaded. I came from Lagos to give you something. No, listen. You've seen our TV programs. How many times have you heard me crying for money? Send me money, otherwise I wouldn't be on air next week. Have you heard me talk like that? Loaded. In every station. Yep. Hallelujah. In every station where we are all over the world, every station, we pay ahead of time. Not behind. We don't beg them for one more week before we'll send the money. No. Ahead of time. In Europe, they are amazed that we'll pay ahead of time. In Canada, the man could not believe it when we said, we'll pay you ahead. No credit card. We'll pay your head. How? The fear of Isaac. That's what Jacob called him. He called him the fear of Isaac. Hallelujah. He's the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. He's not dead. He's the man who can change you. Listen, as you're sitting there tonight, he will alter your destiny. While you were going like this to destruction, you would suddenly be going like this. Glory to God. Hallelujah. That's why we came. I'm telling you, that's why we came. We came to put this thing in your hand. We came to put it right in your heart. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. You will come to the point in your life where, are you ready for the last one here? Let's see something in Genesis chapter number 6. Let's see what God said. In verse 17 again, I read from 17 into 18. And behold, I, even I, do bring a flood of waters upon the earth to destroy all flesh, wherein is the breath of life. Remember, God's talking to Noah here. And then he says, wherein is the breath of life? From under heaven, and everything that is in the earth shall die. But with thee. Hey! But with thee. There's a difference. But with thee. With thee. Everybody say, with thee. But with thee will I establish my covenant. Oh my. With thee will I establish my covenant. God says, I'm going to destroy everyone else, but with you. A flood of economic disasters coming. A flood of hunger is coming. A flood of penury is coming. A flood of poverty is coming. But with you will I establish my covenant. How can God do it? Underline that place. Go to Deuteronomy. The book of Deuteronomy. But with you. With you. Say with me. With me. With me. All right, look at it here. Verse 18, chapter 8, Deuteronomy chapter 8, verse 18. But thou shalt remember the Lord thy God, for it is he that giveth thee power to get wealth. Ah, to do what? That he may establish his covenant. Now, God says, and listen, he says, it is he that giveth thee power to get wealth, that he may establish his covenant. In other words, if God is going to establish his covenant, he will give you power to get wealth so that the covenant will be established. That means power to put. Listen, the anointing of God's spirit is talking to you. He's talking about, he looked at the whole world. It was corrupt. There was violence. There was wickedness. He said, Noah, with you, I will establish my covenant. What does that mean? It means you will produce righteousness. You will produce righteousness. I'm going to join myself with you so you can produce righteousness in your environment. Now he says, he gives you power to get wealth so that you can produce righteousness. You can establish the covenant, establish righteousness, establish the presence of God in your environment. How can God deal with the corruption? How can God deal with the violence? How can he deal with the wickedness? By giving you power to get wealth, that he may produce righteousness. Oh my. Hey, it's here. It's in the word. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Let me just show that to you quickly. Listen. Understand. What is the power to get wealth? To know God's principles and understand his teachings, we have to go to the book of beginnings. Every great truth of the kingdom of God will be found or traced to the book of Genesis. If in Deuteronomy he said, God gives you power to get wealth, the people should ask, what is the power to get wealth? He must have revealed it before. since they did not ask any question, there must have been such evidence in the Word of God. What is the power to get wealth? What power is it that gets wealth? There is the power to plow. There is the power to build. There is the power to swim. Are you hearing me? Different kinds of power. But now he's talking about power to get wealth. There is a wealth-making power. Now, the first man he told, I want you to establish my covenant. I want to establish my covenant with you. We are going to produce righteousness. That man was the first man that God revealed this principle to. Because in his days, there was such wickedness. And God wanted to produce righteousness instead of corruption and wickedness. Genesis chapter 8, verse 22 tells us what power is wealth-making power. It is called seed power. Oh, you didn't hear me. I said it is called seed power. Everybody call it seed power. It says, why the earth remains, seed time and harvest time shall not cease. Listen, he revealed to them wealth-producing power that will produce righteousness. I'm going to show it to you in the New Testament. Just get ready. Just get ready. Seed power is the wealth-producing power of God. Tell somebody, seed power is the wealth-producing power of God. Do you know that the Bible declares that the Word of God is seed? The Word of God is seed. The Word of God is the seed of God. So he understands seed power. And he revealed it to this man. He said, while the earth remains, seed time and harvest time shall not cease. How do we know this is working in the New Testament and that it will actually establish righteousness? In other words, establish his covenant. His covenant is called the covenant of righteousness. You have to understand that. It's called the covenant of righteousness. 2 Corinthians chapter 9. Keda basanta kabaya legrondos gi praktos estali. Thank you, Holy Spirit of God. Oh boy. Next time you find a seed, you will know what to do with it. I'm telling you, next time you see a seed, when God gets a seed into your hand and you have it, you will know that you can produce righteousness with it. You will know you're about to do something that the kingdom of God will shake up anywhere when you take that thing in your hand. Come on, get ready. 2 Corinthians chapter 9. I want to read to you from verse 8. Ready? Verse 7 is powerful, but I'll share that with you another day. Verse 7. So you mark it and wait. Did you hear me? But I want to read from verse 8. And God, everybody say God. God is able to make all grace abound toward you, that ye always having all sufficiency in all things may abound to every good work. Boy, if I took off on that, you'd be here till 12. Verse 9, as it is written, he hath dispersed abroad, he hath given to the poor. Look at me, this is my picture, this is me, he's talking about me. I said, man's talking about me. I don't know about you now, come on, I said, he's talking about me. As it is written, he hath dispersed abroad. Hey, while I'm here right now, someone somewhere in the United Kingdom, Someone in Belgium, someone in the Netherlands is hearing welcome to Atmosphere for Miracles while I'm here now. You understand what I'm talking about? No, we didn't beg them to put us on air. We paid for it. Are you still there? Okay. Hey, as it is written, verse 9, he had dispersed abroad, he had given to the poor, his righteousness remained forever. Look at that. The giver's righteousness is established. It's not true yet. Verse 10. Now, he that ministereth seed to the sower, both minister bread for your food and multiply your seed sown and increase the fruits of your righteousness. You see what I mean? The guy's producing righteousness, talking about the works of righteousness. He says the fruits. He would increase the fruits of your righteousness. How? Through seed power. Did you hear me say seed power? Seed power. Say seed power. Say seed power. Now he that ministers seed to the sower, the one who gives seed to the sower, says he that gives seed to the sower, may God give you seed. Amen. I said, may God give you seed. Amen. May God give you seed. Amen. Says the one who gives seed to the sower, both minister bread for your food and multiply your seed sown. He's saying that your seed that you sow would increase. He should multiply your seed sown and increase the fruits of your righteousness. You see, the seed and the righteousness are tied together. In other words, the seed and the covenant of righteousness are tied together. And he revealed this to Noah. No wonder the Bible tells us Noah walked with God. He walked with him. He walked with God. Are you still in this place? Say, I will walk with God. I have made up my mind. I will walk with God. I will walk with God. Lastly, when David got a hold of this, you know what he called it? He called it precious seed. Precious. It became precious to David. He loved the revelation. He called it precious. What made it precious? It was what he could produce. It was what was inside the seed. The power. Seed power. Seed power. Somebody say seed power. Look at Psalm 126 quickly. He called it seed power. Verse 5 is enlightening. But I wouldn't dwell on that yet. Look at verse 6. He that goeth forth and weepeth, bearing, call it. He says, the one who's weeping has hope if he has precious seed. Look at what will happen here. He that goeth forth and weepeth, bearing precious seed, shall doubtless, goodness, he shall doubtless, oh my, hey, many of you believe in the law of gravity, this one is stronger. He shall doubtless come again with rejoicing, bringing his sheaves with him. He that goeth forth and weepeth, bearing precious seed, is there. His whole hope is in his seed. He's crying. They've taken his house. They've taken his wife, his husband, or her husband, the child. I've been failing the exam so much. I've lost my job. Everything I ever worked for is gone. He that goeth forth and weepeth, if he has precious seed, the Bible says he shall doubtless come and talk about ya. By the time he leaves that place, he shall doubtless come again not with tears, with rejoicing, bearing his sheaves with him. Oh, glory to God. The question is, who has seed? Your seed is your hope. We're talking kingdom finance. Your seed is your hope. Did you hear what I said? That's where it is. It's called seed power. Seed power is the wealth-making power. That is what it is. Your seed power is your wealth-making power. This is the one, the Spirit tells us, the one who has precious seed shall doubtless come again. It says, mark that man. You can write it down. He will surely come back, not with tears, but with rejoicing. Not